Merry Christmas from a Mogwai. This is your festive look at the NECA Toys Gremlins Santa Gizmo. This exclusive limited edition Santa Gizmo by NECA includes a Santa hat, candy cane, and trumpet. Gizmo has a brand new head sculpt based off the original movie and comes with movable eye feature fans love. Now, before we get a closer look at Santa Gizmo, the first thing we're going to want to do is figure out how tall the figure stands. Now, I'm going to take the tape measure to the top of his hat. In case you're curious, and I'll mention it again in this review, the Santa hat is not removable. I'm going to stop it right there. According to the readout, you're looking at Santa Gizmo standing 4.5 or 4.5 inches in height. And switch that quickly to centimeters. Quickly, quickly, quickly. And you're looking at Santa Gizmo standing almost 11.5, 11.4 to be exact. Let's get some size comparisons out of the way. I'll bring in Ultimate Gizmo. Always seems to be the case that I bring in Ultimate Gizmo when I'm comparing Mogwais to new Gremlin releases. They say everybody deserves a second chance during the holiday season. Maybe what a better example to give than maybe Ultimate Gizmo. A figure that was plagued with problems, more so with his trackball eyes. And if there ever was a good example of a figure that NECA should re-release down the road, I think it's definitely Ultimate Gizmo. He definitely deserves, like I said, a second chance. Shucks. Bringing in other examples, we can bring in the Ultimate Gremlin. I don't think this one is tagged with anything. It's not Streaker Gremlin or anything like that. It's just literally, this is an Ultimate Gremlin. But I mean, again, it's the same Gremlin that we've gotten every single time, just with, of course, different accessories. Now, you'll see there's a big empty space to the right of Gizmo. Is that for the lone chair where Tiny Tim used to sit? No, actually, that's kind of depressing. But what it is, though, is a space that I can bring in the Ultimate Santa Stripe. Finally, we have ourselves a Santa Stripe to go along with Santa Gizmo. And even though technically the materials that they used are different, with the newer released Stripe, he actually got afforded some material for his hat. Santa Gizmo, on the other hand, is using just plastic for his hat. But it's certainly these two figures above all else, the Gizmo and the Stripe, are ones I'm definitely putting out every single year for Christmas. I always used to really put out Santa Gizmo on his own, and he was felt vacant and alone. Now I can actually bring in Santa Stripe and display the two on my mantle. Now, Santa Gizmo here does come with two accessories. Since the time he was first initially released, he's never gotten a re-release, so he is a little harder to come by nowadays. But if you are lucky enough that you still have this one in your collection, or you've managed to find one at a decent price, these are the accessories that you would expect to find inside the packaging if you decide to open this up for yourself. Maybe it's a present that you want to keep sealed. And maybe through the virtue of this review, you guys can see firsthand the things that would have come included with Santa Gizmo. It's my gift that I can give to you. It comes included with a candy cane. Now, one other comparison that I didn't make, and I really should have done as a comparison, but I wanted to kind of wait until he was on his own. I guess I can actually move him over a little bit. We'll bring in the little tiny Gizmo that came included with Stripe. The reason it reminded me is when I'm looking at the candy cane on the Santa Gizmo release. Remember the one that came included with Santa Stripe is this one right here. You know, he is an adorable little critter. Some people actually enjoy this guy being the proper size for the Mogwais because they're a lot smaller. A lot smaller, of course, than the regular Mogwais that NECA released. But you remember he came included with a candy cane. And in case you were curious, if it was a re-released candy cane to the one that came included, there he is, the one that came included with Gizmo, it isn't. It is smaller. If you are curious as well, can you take the candy cane that comes included with Santa Gizmo and fit it into the hand of little miniature Gizmo? Well, the answer is yes. It doesn't fit as well in his hand. I don't know really the real reason for it, but it just doesn't seem to clamp as much into his hands as well as the other one does. But you can technically display this Gizmo with this candy cane if you wanted to. I still love this guy. I would love to even get more of these. I don't know what they would necessarily call it, retro gremlins. Maybe do some sideline where you would get like little smaller plastic versions of these guys. I definitely would like to get more of them. But that's certainly a topic for another day. So he does come included with the candy cane. Actually, you know what? That was the one that came with Santa Stripe. This is the larger one. This is the one that came included with Gizmo. And it doesn't have as much the afforded striping, the stripage you would see. Let's just bring this one back in. I definitely think that this one looks a lot nicer, the one that came included with stripe. Much big, bolder red stripes. That's the way it should be. This one's a lot thinner, but as you can see, there's the difference between the two. It does also come included with a trumpet. A trumpet is nice. It's painted all in gold. One of the things I've noticed about my trumpet, and maybe the case across the board, is it comes as a piece that's sectional. I don't know if it's just the fact that there wasn't enough glue on the pegs here. It's not a case where it's broken, because you can actually just take it, line the pegs up to the holes, fit that in place, and the trumpet's as good as new. The downside, though, is to both the accessories, the things we just talked about, the candy cane and the trumpet, neither one of the accessories actually fit into his hands, simply because his hands, as you'll see right now, his hands are your typical Mogwai hands. There's absolutely no way that you can fit them in there. I mean, if you take the candy cane, which you would think is the easier of the two, there just isn't enough of an open slot between his thumb and his pointer finger to be able to wedge the candy cane in there. I think in other occasions when I've displayed Gizmo for myself, usually what I do is like I take like a little, it's like this clear kind of, it's not matte tack, but it's kind of like a little clear adhesive kind of goop. And it is removable, but I usually use a little bit of that and I stick that to his hand. You could also use a clear elastic if you have a couple of those from your other figures. Hold on to those. I always hold on to those in a little tiny container. Maybe not that small. That's ridiculously small. But I usually keep them in a small container. And if I ever need like clear elastics to attach accessories to figures, I usually use those. But neither one of the accessories actually do fit into his hand, even like the trumpet. I think even in the picture that they advertised Gizmo for, no, it wasn't holding it like that. That looks a little silly. But I think they actually just had it sitting in front of the figure. It's not something that really even was supposed to fit in the figure's hands in the first place. I wish they could have at least molded brand new hands and give him the necessary means to actually hold those accessories that he comes included with. Now, when this figure was initially released, it was advertised as having a brand new head sculpt. I'm going to move this guy out of the, well, not out of the way completely. I'll just move him over for the time being. And I want to bring in Ultimate Gizmo. Ultimate Gizmo came later. Well, later in the sense that he came after like the first run of Mogwais that Gizmo was a part of. And I do see when I'm looking at the two that the Ultimate Gizmo that had the faceplate, this specific one right here, because remember the faceplates were all removable. You don't believe me? You should always believe me. You can go ahead and take this plate off. That's shocking. And he actually had a couple of interchangeable face swaps that just plugged into place. The problem was, and maybe something I'll talk about if I ever do a review of this guy again, is that the balls, the trackballs, never fit far enough forward. So it always sort of looks like the trackballed eyes are really pushed back. The point I was, though, making, or at least trying to make, was I think that this faceplate that they used for Ultimate Gizmo was actually pulled from Santa Gizmo with his wonky looking eyes, because they do seem like they are identical to one another, specifically the nose and the mouth area. So this one was probably an introduction to that new mold, and then it was carried over again when they re-released it as the Ultimate Gizmo. I'll just move this guy out of the way. Maybe one of these days, I say to myself, I'll get around to re-reviewing him. But of course, the big notable difference, outside the fact that he has a brand new sculpted head, the fact he does have a Santa hat. It's not removable. You can't pry it off. I suppose you could pry it off, but you would do destructive damage and run upstairs crying that you broke your gizmo. But it doesn't seem to be removable, so I would just leave it alone. It's all molded in red plastic, and it's been painted the fur on the front in red and white, and of course a little pom-pom size painted in white. It's not bad. I mean, in a way I'm disappointed the fact it doesn't have the removable hat option. But then again, the way that it would have been attached, I guess you could always get a small enough, I jokingly say this, but if you got yourself like a small animal hat, like a Santa hat made for cats, it's got to be such a thing that exists. You probably could even just use a Santa hat like that, that's made of fabric, and just put it on a regular Gizmo figure if you want like an upgrade to what you're getting here. It's not to say that maybe down the road that NECA may not re-release this guy with a real fabric hat that's removable. In the time being, though, the one that we have gotten from them has a molded red plastic hat that you can't take off. The detailing on his face is good. We'll talk a little bit about the trackball issue in a second. But overall, I'm really happy with the head sculpt here. It is slightly different, but I couldn't find my original Mogwai Gizmo to do comparison left to right. The fur is nicely sculpted, and equally so is always nicely painted. I definitely think that Gizmo, as well as the rest of the gremlins, are still the best examples I can give people when they say, what's a good example of a good NECA figure? I usually say between the sculpt and the paint, it's always usually the gremlins. Not maybe necessarily the Mogwai territory, but when you get to the gremlins, it definitely has some of the best paintwork I've seen on the NECA figure releases. So, I mean, certainly when it comes to Gizmo, his paint is top-notch. There is, yes, a little bit of additional flesh tone that you can see has made its way off the eyelid and onto the fur that's right next to it. But I do like the head sculpt, and I might even just say, like, the face paint is a lot better than the one we got with the Ultimate Gizmo. I just feel like he's got a lot more of additional dirt brown that's sort of been layered on top of the plastic. It's much lighter here, and I think it's much more warming and embracing. Warming and embracing. As for the rest of his body, it's basically just stock Mogwai. Not much does get changed here. Of course, you have the trackball feature on the back with the notable jagged teeth. Because, of course, these are two halves put together, and then the trackball is located on the back of it. The rest of the figure, short of the new head, short of the new hat, is pretty much the same Gizmo and the same Mogwai body that we've gotten with other releases in the past. Shall we talk turkey? No? Shall we talk posability? Bless you. Thank you. For the posability on Santa Gizmo, his head is attached to his neck via, of course, a ball joint. You can't even see it, really. It's hidden underneath all this. And because of the size of his head, of course, it goes to say that it does limit a little bit of what you can actually do to the head. You can rotate it back and forth. Move it up, and you can move it down, and you can rock it back and forth, but only by a little bit. Only by a little bit. In addition to that, he does have articulation in his ears. You can move those forward and back, and he does rotate those. You can rotate those all the way around if you wanted to. It almost looks like he's catching rain outside. Oh, you. As for his arms hinge out. This one has always been much looser than this side for me. But, I mean, they're basically just ball jointed in place. You can get a full 90-degree angle bend. In addition to that, you can rotate the arm all the way around as well if you wanted to. He does also have a secondary hinge joint, which is kind of really hard to get to. It relies on you holding this part of the arm and then going in there and rotating the forearm. He does also have a rotation in his hands. These cute, adorable, little, tiny Mogwai hands. Look at the size of them. They're so precious. The rest of his body is basically just, there's no posability to speak of. It's just basically just a big, bulbous piece of plastic that all the other limbs are then attached to. Like his feet, for example. The feet have always been limited. I mean, no matter what Mogwai you end up getting, it's always a case where you really can't do too much with the legs. You can move them forward and back, but if you move the feet too far forward, it usually then throws off his stability when you have him on a shelf. So a lot of times they usually just keep his feet completely straight, like so. And of course, we can talk about the elephant in the room. There's the trackball on the back. Now, these have had varying levels of success over the years that they produced the Mogwai figures. I have to ask the question that if NECA was going to ever go back and re-release these Mogwais, if they would find a different route, or if they would still go and use the trackball system. You'll see there's a big giant hole on the back, and inside of that, there's this ball joint. You can move it around. It flicks and makes a noise when you push your finger against it. But the whole purpose of it is when you move it back and forth, it allows the trackball eyes to adjust as well. You'll find a lot of times when you get these figures for yourself, the eyes do take a little bit of adjusting. Sometimes the eyes don't quite line up with one another. Sometimes they don't move in proper sequence where they're working together. They seem to work against each other a lot of the times. I don't have as much the issue on this one as I do with Ultimate Gizmo. Because again, like when we looked at Ultimate Gizmo, the biggest problem with this guy was that his eyes were so far back. And even then, like the trackball was really loose to get out of this guy. Even get this guy out of the packaging. He was loose right from day one. So again, I don't know what they would do necessarily different. Would it just be a case that they would have a removable plate? Take this off, you know, put your finger in there, move the eyes to where you want them, and then put this back in place? Or if we did get a re-release of not only just Santa Gizmo, but any of the Mogwais, would they still go back to using the trackball system? I would think over the years that they have perfected their figures, they probably would find a better means to do it with the Mogwais, because I really do think that that was always one of the big issues with it. It worked to some extent, but most of the time, the eyes really never quite lined up and moved at the same time. You're always sort of fighting with them. I don't fight it as much here with Santa Gizmo, but it is still a problem with a lot of the Mogwai figures that NECA have released. They say that Christmas is the time of year where you put differences aside and you come together to celebrate the holidays. And that being said, for this one time only, Stripe has decided not to torture poor Gizmo, at least for Christmas. Boxing Day, I'm sure it will resume, and for the rest of the year, this poor guy will be tortured by Stripe. But in the meantime, we can put differences aside, and they can be put on my mantle together with no fighting whatsoever. I do like the idea of putting both of these on my mantle, along with the rest of my garland and Christmas lights. I've got a nice little setup going. These guys will be making appearances most likely only during Christmas. Whereas the rest of the year, the regular Mogwais and Gremlins that NECA Toys have put out do make appearances on my collection shelf, but these two are set aside for the special time of year. That special time where I can actually put these guys out with the rest of the Christmas tree and the Christmas decorations, and it doesn't look too strange. Because if you put them out now and you put them out for the rest of the year, people are going to be like, why are you still keeping your Christmas decorations out? And they have no idea. They don't appreciate these things as much as we do. That being said, underneath the Christmas tree this year, though I know it probably would be too late, perhaps next year, may I make a request to Santa or NECA Toys to re-release Ultimate Gizmo. Fix the problem. There was the issue with, of course, the trackball eyes. And maybe as an addition to that, give him a little tiny Santa hat, similar to what his larger Stripe got, made of fabric instead of plastic. As I said, you could probably even go to your local pet store and get yourself a little tiny cat hat. That would be a strange enough story as well, the going to a pet store and buying a little tiny Santa hat. You then have to explain to everybody in line, I'm not weird. I'm not dressing my cat. I just needed a Santa hat for a figure that I have in my collection that I want to put on display. Yeah, that doesn't sound as strange. Either way, though, I'm just thrilled for the fact I was able to bring out Santa Gizmo again and now finally display him with Ultimate Santa Stripe. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. If you have managed to pick up Santa Gizmo for yourself or Santa Stripe, let me know what you guys think of these. And if you'd love to see NECA Toys bring back the Mogwais, because up to this point, we're only really getting Ultimate Gremlins. Not really getting much in the way of Ultimate Mogwais, just throwing that out there. Maybe there will be a surprise underneath my Christmas tree next year. Just fingers crossed, I'm hoping. If you guys are liking the channel and enjoying all the content you're seeing here on a regular basis, and let's just say, right now, you can think to yourself, I had a whole list of things I was supposed to be doing. Yes, I was supposed to go get the milk. Yes, I was supposed to shovel outside. Yes, I was supposed to put away those plants because, of course, they'll die during the winter season. But what was there? There was something else I was supposed to be doing. Let me just throw in the reminder that if you haven't already done so, hit the subscribe button for this channel. Turn the bell notification on and just know that Monday to Friday, 12 p.m. and 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time is when new videos will be popping up. It's going to be tons of new NECA reviews lined up and coming your way, so as always, keep your peepers peeled to this channel. And as always, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.